the Panopto Video Capture Tool in D2L. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the Panopto Video Capture Tool to record, edit, and share videos for your class. We have a lot to cover in this video, and I'm going to move rather quickly, so remember that you can pause and rewind me anytime that you need. So let's get started. For this demonstration, I will be using a laptop running Windows 8, and I will be using the Mozilla Firefox web browser. Panopto will also work on any current Mac computer and any popular web browser such as Internet Explorer, Google Chrome, and Safari. Based on your operating system and your web browser, the user interface may look a bit different to you, but all of the options should be available to you. So I begin by opening my web browser and I log into D2L. From the D2L homepage here, I access my course, and I'll be using a demo course that I set up a bit earlier. And then from my course homepage, I access my course's content by clicking on the Content tab. And then I navigate to the Panopto Video Capture Tool link. This link should be somewhere in your course's content. Mine happens to be right in Module 2 here. And I click on the link to sign into Panopto. This brings me into the Panopto Video Capture Tool. On this initial screen here, you will see any videos that have been posted by your instructor. However, if you want to create your own videos, the first thing that you'll want to do is access the Panopto Dropbox. To access the Panopto Dropbox, click the triangle next to your course's title, then click on the right-facing arrow next to your course's title in the drop-down menu, and then click on your course's Dropbox folder. The course title should now update to show that you are in a Dropbox folder. Now, to begin creating your own video, you can click on the blue Create button. From here, you have two options. You can use the Panopto recorder to capture your screen or video from a web camera, or if you've already recorded your video on an external device, such as a camcorder or a smartphone, you can click the Upload Video option, allowing you to upload your video file directly from your computer into Panopto. So let's say that I want to record my screen with the Panopto recorder. I click the Record a New Session option. Before I can start recording, I'll need to download and install the Panopto recorder, so I click on the appropriate option. Again, I'm on a Windows computer, so I select the Windows option. This program shouldn't take more than 3 or 4 minutes or so to download and install. After the program downloads, you're going to want to make sure to complete the installation on your computer. So I'm going to cut the video here, and we'll come back after a few minutes and after the recorder has been installed. If you haven't already done so, I would recommend that you pause the video now and install the Panopto recorder on your computer. After the recorder is installed on your computer, it should launch automatically. But in case it doesn't, you can now launch the recorder either from your computer, just like any other application, or you can launch it through the Panopto Dropbox. Do you remember how to do that? Good! So from the Content tab in D2L, I click on the Panopto Video Capture Tool link. I click the triangle next to my course's title. I click the arrow next to my course's title in the drop-down menu. And I click the Dropbox folder. Then I click Create. I click Record a New Session. And to launch the recorder, I click Launch Recorder. And this is the Panopto recorder on a Windows computer. If you're using a Mac, the interface is going to look quite a bit different to you. Many of the options that you see here are instead available in the File menu at the top of the screen, or in one of several separate windows. Before you begin recording, make sure that you select the appropriate settings for your video. For example, you're going to want to make sure that your class's Dropbox folder is selected and that the video and audio sources are selected and working. When you're ready, click the big red record button to begin your recording. When you're finished, click the stop button to end your recording. Your video should automatically upload to your Panopto Dropbox folder in D2L. You will still need to share your video in Panopto before others can see it. When your video completes uploading and processing, you will have a few different options. You can click View to watch your video. You can click Edit to make some simple edits to your video. Or you can click the Share button to share your video and get your video's sharing link. So I'm ready to post my video now, so I click on the Share button. This will launch my web browser and allow me to change the sharing options of my video. By default, only you and your instructor will be able to view your videos. If you want your classmates to view your videos, you're going to need to share your video with everyone who can sign into this site. So to do that, click on Everyone Who Can Sign Into This Site, and then remember to click Share. And finally, you may need to post your video's share link to your class discussion so that others can easily find your video. To do this, copy the share link. And in order to do that, I'm going to click on the link. And then to copy it, I press Control and C, as in cat, on my keyboard. And now that it's copied, I navigate to my class's discussion board in D2L. And I access the appropriate topic. In my case, I'm going to go ahead and start a new thread. And I click the Insert Quick Link button in the upper left-hand corner to add my link. In the URL field, I paste my link by pressing Ctrl and V, as in Victor, on my keyboard. And in the title field, I again press Ctrl and V to paste the link to my video. Finally, I set the target to New Window. And this step is very important. If you don't set the target to New Window, your link will not work. I then click Insert, and my link is now in my discussion post. Now I finished my post by giving it a title and adding in some comments about my video. And I click Post to post my video. And finally, I click on my link to test it out. And that wraps up this brief introduction to the Panopto Video Capture Tool. But before I end this video, I want to mention one more thing about Panopto. Unless your videos are shared publicly, Panopto videos are secure and require sign-in to view. Panopto does not use a username and a password like many other systems. Instead, you log into Panopto by clicking on the Panopto Video Capture Tool link within your D2L course. If you ever see this screen here, remember to go back to D2L and click on the Panopto Video Capture Tool link. And that wraps up this video. I hope this video was informative for you, and I thank you for watching.